We just finished talking about keyboard shortcuts in Capture One. Now let's continue on and talk about toolbars that Capture One has to offer. The toolbar itself is really important because it contains a lot of tools for navigational purposes, a lot of checking tools for focus, and things like that. So let me jump into it and show you how things are operate and where they're located. We left off here with this view where we have things auto-hiding the left corner and the right corner. I will quickly go ahead and turn that back on. So I will say manual view. There we go. And then Command B, bring that back. And I will also go back down here and show tools. And we can also go back into our shortcuts and change it to auto mode or manual mode. And then we can also show tools so that we have it visible all the time, since this is our default view that we are sticking to with Capture One. Now, the navigational toolbar is going to be up top here. And I'll also show you some of the other tools that are located across the right hand of the spectrum. This, by default, contains a series of tools that we're going to ultimately use, but we have quick access to them. We can also customize them. If I right-click next to the toolbar itself, I can customize toolbar. And so this right here is the default set. You can also add a lot of these other options into it. Like, for example, if you want to export a variant, I can drag this and bring it to the left-hand side or to the right-hand side and place it there. I can also bring it closer here and change it accordingly. But for now, most of these features are, in a sense, there. For example, we have the process, which we can process here, and we'll talk about processing and exporting later. We can have things like copying adjustments, which already is there. So we don't really need any of these others, because this is only if you're trying to place it, say, here as well and not here. So for now, everything else looks great. We can take this and keep it how it is, and we'll keep these how they are as well, because we're going to talk about these little features going forward. But that's where you find how to actually customize what you see and don't see, or what you want to keep and not keep. So let's get out of there. We'll click Done. First thing is going to be our selection. Now this pointer is going to be the tool that we use most of the time, and when this is selected, it allows us to go to each of these images. It allows us to actually click on everything. So I will keep that as is. There's nothing really special particularly about that. And Capture One is very much like Photoshop in that there's many ways to do things, many shortcuts in order to select things. But you know, as long as you know where it is, it serves as a good starting point. The shortcut for that is V. If you notice, by hovering over it, it tells you what the shortcut is. The next important feature is going to be this pan tool, which is the hand in Photoshop, if you're familiar with this. And what this does is, if you zoom in, right, and if I have my arrow selected, I can click on the pan tool, and the pan allows me to quickly check out the rest of the image. So even if I'm not on the pan tool, the way that I work personally is I keep it on the arrow tool. And when I want to use that tool, I can hold down spacebar and it temporarily brings up that pan tool. Very similar to Photoshop. If you use Photoshop quite a bit, you know that if you use a spacebar, the hand tool comes up so you can move the image across the canvas, even if you're zoomed in. That is a feature that I like a lot. The same thing goes for the zoom in, zoom out. I don't click on the tool and then zoom in and then hold it down and then go to zoom out and then zoom out. I simply just hit the Z key. And the Z key, because I have my shortcuts, is set to zoom in and zoom out by default. So if I hold Z and then Z option goes to the other one. So Z goes to zoom in, Z and Option together, change the Zoom Out tool, and I can zoom out. Next, we have a feature that I think is a very strong point in Capture One, because let's say you are zoomed out, right? Let's say you're shooting really fast and you're tethering, for instance, or you're just going through these thumbnails and you don't want to bother with maximizing or zooming in all the way just to see things are in focus. This tool allows me to see if it's in focus. So check this out. I have this third to the left palette checked down or hold down, and then it brings up these other ones. So this loop tool, P, which is a shortcut, I can hover over an area that I want and just push or click over her face, for instance. So you notice what happens? It allows me to get 100% view and quickly just do a little peek. And the loop tool is very useful. I use this a lot. I mean, I don't really zoom in all the time for everything, but I will use the loop tool to just get a sneak peek of check out some of the detail. I'm not gonna say anything bad, but check out some of the detail here. Like you can see if it's in focus, what the clarity's like, and so forth. Also at the bottom, after I enable the loop tool, it gives me some options, like loop size. I can say large, if I'm working in a small space, and it generates a massive view, or even better, I can change the loop size to small, because I just need something really quick. The other option is I can change the magnification. So if it's 100% now, I can change it 25%. And so it only zooms in 25% of the way, which is pretty much what it's doing by stock. So I'll change that back to large. I'll change that to 100%. And I can say centered zoom, centered loop. And so it just, covers the face. I don't like centered because I want to see what I'm looping into. I want to see what's physically happening, so I can just put it off to the side. That is a really key feature for me.